Hello friends, this is Durga again from IT Varsity. At this time we are talking about joins. Let's continue talking about cogroup and Cartesian. So already we have seen outer joins and inner joins, and we have seen that when we actually join data sets of type KV and KW, it will result in a new tuple of this type, where for each key we will get the corresponding values from both the data sets, and we have seen that in action. Now if you look into cogroup, when you actually cogroup two data sets of type KV and KW, it will result in another tuple where key will be the common key between both the data sets, and value will be iterable of this one and iterable of this one, which means the collection of type value of from the first data set and the collection of type value of second data set. So now let us see in action. We have already created the orders and order items, and you can run cogroup. It's the syntax is same as join. Only thing is, instead of join we are actually saying cogroup in this case, and you paste it here, and you can see each element in RDD after cogrouping two data sets is of type tuple, where the first element is of type integer, which is order ID from both the data sets, and the second element is of type tuple, and the elements in the tuple are nothing but collection from respective data sets. Now you can actually perform orders cogroup dot count to validate or to perform some sanity checks. You will find the count will be exactly same as the orders. In this case, orders also have 68,883 records. When we join, the number is close to order items. In this case, the number is close to orders, because here for each order ID there will be only one record, and for that one record we will have a collection of associated data sets, which is orders and order items in this case. If you preview the data by saying orders cogroup dot take of 10 dot for each println, you will see the key as first element, and then as part of second element you see two compact buffer. Compact buffer is nothing but a type of implicit collection or implicit iterable which will be generated. I don't know why it is named as compact buffer, and I'm not 100% sure about internals of it, but here it is nothing but collection. And even though it is collection, we know that orders have only one order ID, only one record for each order ID, because it's primary key in its source database. Hence the first compact buffer only have one record all the time, whereas the second compact buffer can have multiple records from the order items, because there can be more than one order item for each order. So that is about cogroup. And then if you look at Cartesian, Cartesian takes two data sets of type RDD, which is nothing but a distributed collection, and it will create a new collection or new distributed data set or RDD of type T, U, and you will get all combinations of T and U. So let us do an example and you will understand. So for this one, I am actually using sc.parallelize and creating RDD using simple collections. So here one, I am invoking parallelize with a simple list which have four elements, and let me run this one also. This one have only two elements. So A is one RDD and B is one another RDD. A have four elements and B have two elements. Now if I say A dot Cartesian of B and then say collect for each println and hit enter, you see it has created 8 records, because when it comes to Cartesian, the number of elements will be multiplication of the size of both the data sets. This one have 4 and this one have 2, hence it has generated 8 tuples as part of this new RDD. So that is about Cartesian. So these are the join operations which are supported as part of Spark. We have started with inner join, we have gone through left outer join, right outer join, full outer join. We have also seen them in action. We have seen left outer join, right outer join and inner join in action. And then I have covered about co-group, and we have seen Cartesian product as well. So one more thing you need to keep in mind when it comes to co-group is, as these are collections, you can perform some collection based operations on these data set beyond co-group. So for example, if I just want to get number of elements from each of the data set, I can say val orders co-group, okay, not val, I just have to say. So co-group is nothing but a RDD of type tuple, where the first element is order ID and the second element is tuple. Okay, so in this case I just want to get order ID from each record, and then I want to get size of each of the iterables of orders and order items, which is nothing but the inner tuple after co-group. So as we are taking one record as input and generating another record as output, we can use map function and say rec imply rec dot underscore 1 comma rec dot underscore 2 dot underscore 1 dot size rec dot underscore 2 dot underscore 2 dot size. Okay, we have to close 3 times, one for this one, one for this one and one for this one. Yeah, it looks good. And then I can say take off 10 for each println and hit enter. Now you see, for each order ID I got the size of the first data set after co-group and the size of second data set after co-group. Okay, like that you can apply whatever transformation you want using other transformations at both RDD level as well as the collections which are created as part of co-group. And we'll see those things in much more elaborate examples once we cover all the important transformations and actions in detail. That being said, thank you. Bye.